So we're here with the Danish Technological Institute. So who are you?
I'm Leif Christensen. I'm director for the center at DTI.
And who are you?
Yeah, my name is Zachary Davis. I'm also a senior researcher at DTI.
So what's going on at DTI?
So basically what we're doing at DTI is development of nanomaterials for printed electronics applications. So in this case, we are... You want to see that? So basically, we are doing all the way from basic process development of so trying to figure out what types of nanomaterials are needed and trying to develop those materials, to scaling up, researching and developing methods to produce in small, but also scale up the production for large scale production, maybe tons a year of these type of nanomaterials.
So what's going on at the DTI? What are we looking at in the video there?
Yeah, what we show here is the part of this supercritical reactor system to produce nanomaterials. So what you see there, it goes too fast maybe, but you see some of the chemicals coming out here. And I think we'll go out a little bit so we can see more of this, maybe come to the situation where it's finished, let us look. And this is a catalyst materials produced. Here's one of our guys that, and a lady also, that produce these kind of materials here. So we can produce a lot of different things with this reactor. You can make catalyst materials for fuel cells. You can make catalyst materials for diesel exhaust system for diesel trucks. And you can use it for printed electronics. There's a lot of different things you can do.
So what's going to happen with printed electronics? What are you going to do with that?
Well, right now we are developing. We have developed a little bit nano silver for silver based things, but also heavily investing a lot of money and effort into nano copper, because the idea is that if you can make a conductive ink out of copper instead of silver, that's just as good performance wise electrically. Then you can do it in a very cheap way. So replacing silver could with copper could lead to very cost-effective printed electronics, which is one of the main challenges that a lot of the industry is facing, is the price. How to reduce the price of production of these printed electronical systems. So
how do you do that? Kind of, is it research?
We're doing both research, but also innovation. So and development towards and all the way up to commercialization with companies. So typically, a company comes to us with a challenge. We try to map out what options are there for solving that challenge, and then help them in collaboration with them to solve these challenges, right? So going all the way from and that could be from a concept, so we do the basic research, or taking some other existing research and then develop that into something that the company can use in a market.
So what's your experience in the industry? Danish Technological Institute is doing a lot of stuff and ready to be at the front leading edge of nanotechnology?
If we'll be the leading edge, it has to be proven, of course, but we do a lot of work and we do a lot of research. We also engaged in Horizon 2020 projects with European companies and also European universities. So we have to collaborate to bring things up. And it takes some time, we guess that 3 or 5 years before we have the ink ready for that.
So 3 or 5 years?
Yeah, could be. Yeah.
And then what happens then? You work with companies and they ship it? How does it work?
Well, that's different, right? I mean, we can of course produce the materials ourselves and give them the raw materials to make nano inks. We can also develop processes and license those processes together with an ink reactor or a nanomaterial reactor, which they can buy. So that we're very flexible in that, depending on the needs of the company, the needs of the industry, right? If they wanted to just buy the material, we can sell the material. Or if they want to have it in-house, then we can also do that, develop that.
So what do you think about the ID Tech X, the print electronics industry, and what's going on here?
Quite interesting for us to come here and see all the things that are presented here, but also have an opportunity to present something that we have created in Copenhagen. And we think we'll be there next time as well in Berlin next year in April.
So a lot of activity happening with printed electronics, right? And
yes,
with all the other events happening
right here.
We've
been around, worked, walking around to see things and discuss with us. There's a lot of people there. A lot of applications, very broad.
I mean, And that's one of the things we really want to do, is to see, you know, other companies, what they are doing, whether can they use this technology, what type of what specifications do they have, and what needs do they have for this type of technology, so we can actually, you know, adapt what we're doing to fit the needs of the companies, right? So it's very important to talk to these companies and see what's happening.